Welcome to Massive Beers. My name is Matt. We do the beer stuff here. Mystery beers. Yeah. Courtesy of my boy Cameron out of Wisconsin. Shooting beer all over the place. Yeah, mystery beers. We have no idea what they are. People send them. I guess inanimate objects could send them, and weird things could send them, and it doesn't have to be people, it could be aliens. Well, aliens are people too. So we have no idea what we're drinking, except we do, because it's called Hazy IPA. Number 4 in Cameron's series here, and what do we have? We have what looks like a Pilsner, a nice Pilsner glass. No, it's definitely a big old hazy, super thick, turbid, hazy style hazy. With super hazies and all the hazies. I always forget I get horrible noses out of the shape of glass. So let's see if we can get something going on. Yeah, it's super citrus leaning. Super citrus leaning. Kind of like one of those ones with that slight little fluttery dusting of lactose. Little bit of peachiness going on. And that's pretty much it. But it's very much the assault of orange. All the orange arbolona thus on this. Smells to me like a really heavily dosed kind of 6-7% IPA. Let's dive in. Cheers, y'all. Sweet. 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 It's got kind of almost like candy-like sweetness that's tempered slightly, but by what I assume is that subtle dose of that lactose. So it's not like overtly super sharp sweet, but it wants to get there. There is a bittering that kind of builds. When I first took a sip, it was a sweetness and fruit juiciness. Very much juicy fruit gummy is the way this kind of comes off. But as that sweetness kind of fades away, that bitterness kind of builds. I don't think it's necessarily a bittering beer, but I think it's so heavily dosed with hops, it's just hard to keep that kind of green bittering at bay. I want to call this high sixes to low sevens, but I really do think this probably ekes into the eights because of the sweetness here. I think it might be slightly under attenuated. So even though it probably is more in that low 7% range, I think the can's going to read 8.82. And, ooh, big burp. There's another one. There's a thinness to it. I wouldn't necessarily call it a thin beer, but for its style, it's a bit thin. And I think that kind of detracts a lot from the beer. You know, the style of beer that this is. A hazy double IPA, copiously hopped. Probably with something a bit boutique-y. Like there might be a little Sabro in here. It's not just Citra, Mosaic, Galaxy, those kind of things. There's Cashmere, or Idaho 7, maybe, or Sabro, or Enigma, like one of those kind of newer, kind of cooler hops in here, because there is some kind of soft, kind of like coconut-esque kind of component to it. But it just kind of lacks that sultry, super silky, pillowy mouthfeel that you really want from these kind of beers. So either it just missed that mark with the mouthfeel, or it has a little bit of extra time on it. So I'm going to call it an 8.2%. Hazy IPA with a couple different hops in it, but I'm going to go a Sabro Enigma mix just for the sake of conversation and for me calling out some hops. Done and done. A good hazy brewer, I think, but just missed the mark a little bit on this one. So, let's see what we got going on. Do I have to guess anything else? Guess the ABV. I guess hops. Don't do that a ton. I think we're done. Let's see. Get those off. Come on. Okay. We have here Godfather. Kind of looks like a weird character of John Larroquette. Eagle Park. Okay, I had Eagle Park from Cameron previously. Cashmere, Lotus, and Belmont hops. So it's Cashmere and Lotus are the hops I couldn't pick out. 7%, so it's not super high in ABV. $18 a 4-pack. Very, very expensive. Yeah, it's a fun beer. It's just that mouthfeel, honestly, just really does let me down. It's probably a skosh too sweet for me too, especially at 7%. I took that sweetness and kind of assumed it was going to be pushing up towards the 8. It was actually closer to the actual ABV that I thought it was. Well, the hop profile and the flavor you get from the hops is fun. It just lacks that mouthfeel. No, it lacks that sultry, silky pillowiness that you really want in these kind of beers. That's pretty horrible. Can art though, man. Look at that thing. Not gonna sit here and say I dig on that. It's very cheesy. Very cheesy. Godfather. Brewed in collaboration with the godfather of craft beer in Milwaukee and the proprietors of Roman's Pub, Mike Romans. So it's with the godfather. I get it now. So it's not as cheesy, but the art still is a little bit there. EagleParkBrewing.com, art by Daniel Walsh. Sorry, Daniel. Yeah, it is what it is. It's a hazy. It was canned 3/14/23. Leave the gun, take the cannoli. It says on a can. You can see it right there. And so we're talking about just about a month old, a little over a month and a half old. Yeah, not a bad beer by any stretch of imagination. $18 a four pack. That's no fun. But it is what it is. And I will keep drinking this. I kind of want to dig into it and see what's going on with it a little bit more. But, you know, it's a fine hazy. I buy this. I picked this up off a shelf for $15. I think I'm like, oh, cool. Yeah, that's fun. I'll drink them. 18, I'm like, it sucks. That's kind of the toe. That line is right there for me, and that's where I land. Anyway, I didn't do too shabby on that one. Call it the wrong hops. Such is life. And Mount Rushmore status is one of the better hazies. Single IPA hazies that I've had is like, no. It's not out of the conversation, just not towards the top. Like I said, value on this is quite high. Or quite low, technically. The value is low, the price is high. Availability, I assume Eagle Park. Actually, did I get Eagle Park stuff from Tavora when they sent me some boxes? Maybe some could be had. And honestly, if you really are a haze bro or hop that or whatever, and you get one of these, I think you're actually going to dig it. You know what I mean? Like, it's not going to light the world on fire. You're not going to kind of be like, this is the best beer I've ever had in my life. But it definitely scratches that itch. So there you go. Review in the books. Mystery beer in the books. If you ever want to sign off mystery beers, you're more than welcome. MadamMassBeers.com. Reach out to me that way. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the review. Hopefully you're enjoying a little mystery beer right now. We'll see you next time. Cheers, y'all.